Oftentimes, when a family starts buying raw milk from a farmer or from a herd share, they get a big batch of milk in all at once, one time a week, and they have to figure out what to do with all of it. So today, I'm going to show you how I take 5 gallons of milk and I turn it into all different types of amazing homemade dairy products, all in about 2 hours of active work time. This is going to be so much fun. We're gonna make a hard farmhouse cheddar. We're gonna make an easy soft cheese. We're gonna make buttermilk, sour cream, yogurt, and even an actual butter all in 2 hours today. I am not going to give you guys a 2 hour long video. So for that, I wanna go ahead and start the timer right here so you can see real time exactly what's happening. On your mark, get set, go. Here I have my 5 gallons of milk and you can see that I'm setting aside about 1.5 gallons over here that I've already skimmed. Now I've got the cream sitting over here, but these are just gonna go right back into the refrigerator for my fresh drinking for the week. My first step is going to be to start my farmhouse cheddar. I'm gonna use 2 gallons of milk to do this. Now this is cream-lined milk. It has not been skimmed. This is going to completely fill this pot up. Why my milk for my cheddar is warming up, I'm gonna go ahead and get my butter started. Now I have this quart of cream that I went ahead and brought up to 62 degrees Fahrenheit just by leaving it out on the counter. Now, this is so easy, you guys. I'm just gonna put it in the KitchenAid back there and turn it on low. We'll just let that work while we move on to the next step, which is to start our buttermilk and our sour cream. I'm gonna go ahead and get this pasteurizing by using my Instant Pot. Not only do I want to make buttermilk, but I want to make sour cream, and I can do those two things at the exact same time. I am going to take about 1 quart of milk, and this is that cream-lined milk. I've not poured off any of the cream yet or skimmed it, so this is a really rich milk already. There was cream on the top. But I'm gonna add to this about 1 pint of just the cream that I skimmed off that other milk. Now, this means that as this buttermilk cultures, it's gonna separate again, that cream's gonna rise to the top, and I'm gonna end up with 2 distinct products. I'm gonna end up with the buttermilk at the bottom, and I'm gonna end up with sour cream at the top. I love this, because I can do 2 things at once. So in order to pasteurize this, I'm just gonna pop it in the Instant Pot. I'm gonna hit the yogurt feature, hit adjust, and set it to boil. Put the lid on, put it to sealing, and just let it do its thing. It's really fast. Now that I have everything working, you heard that that's already going, turned on, I'm gonna go ahead and pour out 1/2 gallon of milk into this pot for an amazing fresh cheese. It needs to come all the way up to 175 degrees Fahrenheit. And here we are at 86 degrees, so we're ready to take our next step. Now I'm gonna go ahead and turn the heat off on this farmhouse cheddar. And the next step is gonna be to add in the culture. Now today we're using our cultured buttermilk. So I wanna just go ahead and pour this in and give it a really, really good stir. It's a little daunting to have so many different things going at the same time, but once you get the hang of each project, it's not a big deal. And you know what? Homemade dairy is actually really forgiving. I am just gonna let this sit now for 30 minutes. Now I'm still waiting for the soft cheese to come all the way up to that 175 degrees. So I'm gonna go ahead and start getting ready for my yogurt. Now I have a second Instant Pot insert and I'm gonna go ahead and start 1/2 gallon of yogurt. So that means I just need to take 1/2 gallon of my raw milk here. for your pasteurized milk, and we're going to pasteurize this. Buttermilk and sour cream has just finished pasteurizing, and I need to cool that down really quickly. So I have here a tub filled with cold water with a little bit of ice. And we'll just set that right on into this pan of water. And now I'm gonna start the yogurt, and I'm gonna do the exact same thing. I'm just gonna put it in, hit that yogurt setting, adjust it to boil, and let it go. This is about to 172. I'm gonna go ahead and turn it off because I know it's gonna heat quite a bit more on this particular range setup. Now I'm ready to go ahead and add my other products, which is gonna be about 2 cups of our home cultured buttermilk. Remember, we have this buttermilk. We're using this as our mesophilic culture, and 1/4 cup of fresh lemon juice. Now this is gonna cause this to curdle right on up. So just stir it, and then we're gonna go ahead and let it sit for about 5 minutes completely undisturbed. We have about 10, 15 minutes left on letting our cheddar culture, and we're just waiting for the butter and the yogurt. So I even have breaks. Oh, this is perfect. This buttermilk is now down right to about 80 to 85 degrees. So we're ready to put our starter culture in for the buttermilk. Buttermilk starter culture is buttermilk. I have 1/2 cup of buttermilk here. I'm just gonna pour it right on in, give it a super, super stir. Now, the great news about buttermilk and sour cream is that they culture at room temperature. That means all I'm gonna do is put a lid on this, and I'm gonna let it sit out at warm room temperature all night. Now, I'm gonna go ahead and pour it into 1/2-gallon jar. If you're doing one of these big batching days and there's a lot going on in the kitchen, make sure you label it so you know what it is. Sour cream, buttermilk. Now we are all done with the sour cream and buttermilk for today. We're ready to set this aside. Let's move back to this fresh cheese. Gosh, you guys, I wish you could smell this. It smells so good. We are all ready to go ahead and take the next step of that. Now that is gonna be to strain it off. And I am going to pour this right on through. This is just gonna take a few minutes here to sit. And then we're gonna be ready to salt it and to put it in a beautiful little bowl. You guys, it doesn't get any easier than that. Look at that, your own absolutely amazing fresh cheese. You can see this isn't that big of a deal. It doesn't take that much work to go ahead and start making all of these great things. I still have another break here where I could go wash a few more pots, because by the time I'm done, I want a clean kitchen and I wanna be able to go ahead and put my feet up. Okay, well, our timer just went off for our culturing. We're gonna be using 1/2 teaspoon of rennet. Pour this right in while stirring. We're gonna let this sit completely undisturbed for another 30 minutes with the lid on. The yogurt in the Instant Pot just went ahead and beeped at me, so I'm gonna get it out and I'm gonna put it in the ice bath. I'm gonna take the next steps of preparing for my cheddar cheese right now while I still have quite a few minutes of break time. The butter's working away. It's taking a little longer than normal today. That is the reality when you're working with a raw cream. It's not always predictable. Now we're ready to go ahead and stir in our yogurt starter culture. So I have that 1/2 cup of really active yogurt. This is from last week's yogurt making here in the house. And then we're gonna go ahead and incubate this. And I like to incubate my yogurt for about 10 hours. I like it nice and strong and a little bit tangy. The big important thing with yogurt is that we need to make sure it stays in that optimal temperature range all the way for that whole amount of time. There are a lot of different ways to manage this. The easiest that I have found, the most simple, is right back in the Instant Pot. I'm just gonna go ahead and turn this to yogurt, and I'm gonna turn it up to the 10-hour mark, and there you have it. I am all done now with the yogurt. until probably tomorrow morning when I check this. There it goes. I need to jump into my next step, which is cutting the curds and cooking the curds. So I have my press set up right here, and I have gone ahead and quick sterilized my mold and my follower, and gone ahead and done the same for my curd knife. The cheesecloth has been boiling. Now, checking to clean break is when we know that the rennet has set our cheese enough and we're ready to move on to the next step. And clean break is really, really important to know how to do. So let's take a look. I'm gonna take the end of my thermometer and I'm just gonna poke this right on in at a 45 degree angle. And then I'm going to pick straight up. Now, watch what that did. I can see that when that split, it split in a nice clean line. And the way that's filling that in is actually nice and clear. It's not all milky. It does not have a lot of proteins left in it. Another way you can do this is just to pull away from the edge and see if your cheese or your milk, your curds here, will actually pull all the way from the edge. And look at that. It's just one big solid mass. So you can see that it's really pulling nicely away from the edge. That means that we have achieved clean break and we are ready to move on to the next step of cutting our curds. This is where our knife comes in handy. We're just gonna go ahead and cut the curds into about a half inch cubes. Now, that's not as easy done as it said because they like to move around while you're cutting. We're gonna let this sit for about 5 minutes to heal. In that time, I'm gonna go ahead and take this cheesecloth and just drape it into my form here. Here is the longest part of cheese making, and that is stirring and cooking the curds. Now, these curds have been healing or sitting without being disturbed for about those 5 minutes. And now we're going to very, very gently start stirring them and very gently starting to heat them. We want to bring this pot of curds and whey up to about 100 degrees in approximately 25 minutes. You want to start off really gentle, both in your stirring and in your heating, and then slowly you can become a little bit more aggressive, but you do want it to be as even as possible. This is a great time to put on an audiobook or listen to your favorite music and just relax in the kitchen. Oh, and I didn't tell you, the butter is now finally done and ready for the next step, but of course, now I've got my hands full. So it's just gonna sit there and wait for me until I have a break in this process, which will be closer to 25 minutes. That's just fine. I had hoped it would be done earlier. It's usually done a little earlier, but that's all right. We'll work with it. While I'm standing here stirring, I wanted to tell you guys all about my brand new masterclass, Practical Homemade Dairy. It's where I take you through all of the steps, every single step to using your great milk, whether it is store-bought milk or it is raw milk, whether it's straight from a cow or a goat or a sheep, or whether it's gone through the farmer or through the grocery store, and turning it into all sorts of amazing dairy goodies that you can make in your home. I teach you step by step in detail every single one of the things that we've done here today, give you all of the recipes, but I also teach you how to do a ton more things. Everything from flavored coffee creamers to feta cheese to a chèvre to Parmesan cheese, how to age it, how to press it, how to brine it or stretch it, whatever the cheese is, I take you through all the steps of it and I show you how to do it in a really practical way that makes it very doable in a really busy lifestyle. And I show you all the DIY tricks, like how to make your own cheese presses, how to rig a cheese cave in your own home. And I show you how to use the existing products if you're in a place in life that you can just go ahead and buy the things that work really easily. check the link in the description to learn more about this class. And hey, if you are a Homesteading Family subscriber, then I'm gonna give you a really, really special deal. So click the link below. These curds are ready to move on to the next stage. Now I'm gonna go ahead and I'm just going to let these curds settle for about 5 minutes. All this is gonna do is I'm gonna allow them to drop all the way down, and hey, that butter is finally done. So we're gonna grab that butter and go up to the sink and wash it really quickly. Washing your butter is really important because you have to get all of that buttermilk out, otherwise it'll go bad really, really quickly. I'm just gonna run cool water right on into this from the sink. At this point, it's usually best just to go ahead and use your hand so you can really get in there. We wanna wash this until it comes all the way clear, just squishing it and squeezing it. Let's go ahead and get this beautiful butter out on a plate. Now, you could just put that in some saran wrap and store it right in the refrigerator. And look at that, you guys, that is not what you buy from the grocery store. Can you see how creamy and beautiful that is? This is so incredibly delicious. The flavor is going to absolutely blow you guys away. These curds have settled on down, so I'm gonna come on over here to where I have my stock pot set, and I'm just gonna very carefully pour off that way. Now we're down just to the curds with a little bit of whey on it, and that is just perfect. We're ready to go ahead and take our 2 tablespoons of salt and add them into the pot and stir them in. So we're just gonna mix that in and go ahead and get our clean hands right on in just to stir it around right into the mold. There we go. Oh, these look so amazing. Can you believe that? We are right at about 2 hours right now of work time, and we've made yogurt, buttermilk, sour cream. We've made a soft cheese. We're just about to wrap up our hard cheese. And look, that's just not that hard. Okay, we're just gonna tuck him in here and get ready for our first pressing. There you have it. We have our hard cheddar. Let it sit on full weight, about 55 pounds of pressure for overnight or until it's done. And then we will come check on it tomorrow. My yogurt has been incubating overnight, and my cheese has been pressing overnight too, and the buttermilk and sour cream. And I don't know if you guys can see how incredibly thick this is. This is so amazing. There's a little line here that I can tell the difference between the sour cream and the buttermilk. This is amazing. It is absolutely not runny at all. Today's work in the kitchen is just gonna take us a few minutes here. Look at that. Okay, so now we have this beautiful, super thick buttermilk that's left in here. And we have this great sour cream ready to go. I'm gonna label that and then get them both into the refrigerator. This yogurt has been sitting well over that 8 hours or that 10 hours because I went ahead and just did it overnight. But you know what? It's fine. We don't need to worry about it being perfect. And can you see how thick this yogurt is? You guys, homemade yogurt does not have to be runny. It doesn't have to be super sour. This is absolutely amazing yogurt. Now for the cheese. Now this has been pressing overnight. Look at this, you guys. This is our very own block of cheddar cheese. This is amazing. Now we're gonna age this cheese. This is a raw milk, so we wanna age it for at least 60 days. Look at all of this amazing stuff. Today it's gonna take me no more than, what, 5 minutes at the most? And I've got all of these great dairy products in about 2 hours of active work on one day with a little bit of follow-up on the next few days. If you want to learn how to do these things, make sure you click the link in the description so that you can make this amazing dairy in just a little bit of time every week. You can learn every step of the way. Check out the Practical Homemade Dairy Masterclass. You will not be sorry you did.